With weeks to go until Rio 2016, it's time to put my sporting skills to the test. Last week, I attempted life as an Olympic hurdler alongside Thomas Barr. Now, that didn't go really well, but today it's time to see if I'm any good at hockey. The Olympic Irish hockey team was announced for Rio last week, so I decided to pop down to Mount Temple School in Clontarf to learn a few hockey skills and see do I have what it takes to score a penalty past the best hockey goalkeeper in the world. Now, I'm not just saying that. Yes, Ireland's David Harte was crowned the world's best hockey goalkeeper last year, so I have my work cut out. Did you know that the Irish hockey team is the first team to qualify for the Olympics since 1948? So we have our faith in the lads to produce the goods, but by the time David gets his goalkeeper's kit on, I don't know how he's not exhausted. My God, that's some amount of padding he has to wear. So, as David is ready, I grab a quick word with him about growing up playing hockey and preparing for the biggest tournament of his life.
Dave, good morning to you. It's great to see you. And first of all, I have to say congratulations to you and the whole team for qualifying for the Olympics.
Yeah, many thanks. We're incredibly excited as a squad and as a group and as an association within Hockey Ireland.
And the Harte family very proud because there's two of yous in it, yeah. Which is a double bonus.
That's true, yeah. My twin brother Connor is also in the squad and plays as a central defender. So you could say a double surprise, obviously, for qualifying with the Harte family.
So how long have you been playing hockey, the two of you?
The two of us both started when we were, I'd say, 12, 13 years old. We started in the secondary school in West Cork. We went to Bandon Grammar School and fell in love with the game there.
And tell me about this. I love this thing that every year there's an auction where clubs all over the world can auction for you to come and play for them. And you were auctioned last year, and you were the second most expensive player ever in the world.
I don't think that's quite right, but I think I was seen as up there as one of the most expensive goalkeepers, which was a fantastic feeling for myself personally, of course. It's known as the Hockey India League tournament that is based usually over January and February of each year and lasts for a period of about 5 to 6 weeks. And essentially, as you mentioned, there's an auction part where you put yourself forward to be selected and get selected by one of the six franchises over there.
You were selected by a team in Mumbai. In India.
Yeah.
Wow. And what's it like? It must be very different.
It's an amazing life experience, along with the hockey experience, of course. It's their second most popular sport behind cricket. You have massive fanatic crowds, and you're treated like royalty over there in some fantastic hotels and bars around the country.
You're putting up, it's 5-star all the way,
isn't it? It is true, yeah.
And then you come back home, and you have to come to here with us and do these type of things. Okay, now my challenge this morning for Challenge Alan, which I think I'm going to put my hands up now and say, obviously a fail because goalkeeper of the year last year, you're dressed like this. So tell us literally about it. Now, what's this called?
It's very simply no real kind of science behind it. It's known as a hockey stick.
Oh, there you go. Hockey stick. There you go. We'll get that out of the way. So the goal, if you're standing, if you're taking a penalty, how far is this about?
It's about 7 meters from the goal as a penalty usually.
Now, this is quite, I thought they'd be like soft things. This is like a bloody...
Unfortunately not, and
it's
hence
like
all the
rock.
Kit.
Yes. It is, it's like a rock.
It's true. You can even the sound of it if you feel it off the stick.
Like, that is tough going. Okay, well, show us how you would do it if you were doing it professionally.
If I was doing it professionally, you'd approach the ball kind of stick distance away from it. You're allowed to step into the ball, obviously, to get a bit of momentum and power behind it.
Yeah,
and ideally, you can flick it wherever you like in the goal, high or low.
Okay, well, off you go. Show us how it's done.
So, show my best.
So you're sort of flicking it up?
Yeah.
All right, okay. Now, you have another, this is a...
I have a particular ball I brought for you today,
Alan. This is a baby ball.
A baby ball. It's a light ball. It's made of similar plastic, but the center of it is actually hollow. So it's usually ideally what kids would use, and also sometimes to make the ball go a bit quicker.
So 4-year-olds would use this. 4-year-olds and Alan use on his challenge, Alan. Right, so I have the baby ball. This should be easy. So after a few practice runs, it's time to see if I can get one past David. The aim is to see if I can score a goal in 3 attempts. Let's go. Ah! Oh. I keep going down the bloody middle. Okay, I'm going to cheat.
Give me 5 shots.
Ah, for God's sake, I took my eye off the ball there. Oh!
Ara could be here all day. I passed my hurling challenge last week, so maybe those skills will work out. Not really. Ara, I give up. There's only one way to score, past David.
Yay! Well done, I admit defeat on this one. As I said, best of luck to you and all the team in the Olympics in Rio. Brilliant. And do us proud.
Many thanks, Alan. Thank you. Thank you.
Before I go, I had to get into the goalkeeper's kit and see if I could make my millions in this position. After a good 5 minutes of getting the gear on, it's time for my sporting moment.
Yeah, see that? Yeah. Okay. Jesus, watch my face. Hey, did you get that?
The best of luck to David and the lads in Rio. And remember, David, if you need a super sub, I'm always available.